Welcome to our series of PowerCore training videos. This video is called Input-Output Menu. We're at the home screen, so we'll hit the menu button and enter our passcode. Hit enter and go down to Input-Output. We have digital inputs, analog inputs, and relay and digital outputs. Digital inputs, hit enter. And you'll see digital input number one is disabled. Two is already set. Two and three are set for floats. Auto start maintained, auto stop maintained. Digital four is set for low coolant level. Digital five is set for low lube oil. And digital six is disabled. You can also set speed set points in digital inputs. Five speeds. You can have five inputs where if you activate those inputs, it goes to a different speed every time you make that input active. Or you could use just one or two of them. So that's quite a feature. So let's change one, just so you get an idea. Digital input one is disabled. The function is disabled. So you hit enter, and there's a menu in here. Let's just choose, go either direction, but let's just choose fuel leak, okay? Which will be shown on the display if this input goes active. You hit enter, fuel leak. Active, it's active on a ground or B minus. You can change that to be active on B plus, or you can change it to where a contact opens when you have the fuel leak. Action for a digital input, not used. If it's not a shutdown, it would be not used, like the float start stop, you would have not used there. You can have it be a warning, a shutdown, a controlled shutdown, which is similar to an auto stop, or you can pull a relay in with it. You can turn a relay output on with it. So let's back up with the back button and go to analog inputs. Analog input one is disabled. So we go to the menu and we have quite a choice. There's a difference between a sender, a resistive sender input, for instance, and a 0 to 5 or 4 to 20 milliamp input. The difference is if you go down here and choose, let's find a DATCON oil pressure sender for analog input one, okay? You're done, because we know what the lookup table is for the DATCON oil pressure, just like we do for the Murphy or the VDO. We know what those lookup tables are, okay? If you go, let's change analog input one to a 4 to 20 input. Gearbox pressure. We don't have the lookup table for that built into the controller. So at the end of the analog menu, there's a sensor setup. When you choose a 0 to 5 or 4 to 20 analog input, this sensor setup appears. You hit enter because you have to tell this controller what 4 to 20 milliamps mean. Okay, 4 milliamps generally equals zero. 20 milliamps in this case would equal 1,000 pounds. Well, we know from experience that a gearbox oil pressure isn't going to be 1,000 pounds. So you would lower this to what 20 milliamps represented. That way we're calibrated. We know what 4 and 20 means and we're linear in between. Relay and digital outputs. Relay one, a 10 amp relay is set for crank. It's a factory default. ECU enabled. Common alarm, not used. You can choose from many things in the menu for relay four to act on. As you come down here, you see the two 5 volt outputs. that are not used. We have two dedicated 5-volt outputs on the MPC20, and you can get in there and choose what you want for those to be activated on. And those are actually 5 volts when they turn on. Digital output, you have digital output 3 and 4 are both high side FETs for 2 amps. You can select what you want those to be. The low side FETs are already assigned to throttle decrease and throttle increase for our mechanical throttle actuator, because we require grounds to be pulsed out for the throttle actuator. So those are already set, but you can change those. Hit the back button back to the input output menu. And that concludes our video on input output. Thank you.